Hello everyone, my name is Smithy and welcome back to another video. So today we're going to be going through my current account goals on my Ironman Dead Smithy. I did do one of these videos about 6 months ago and we went through, first of all, how I set all of my goals, how I've broken down kind of bigger tasks into smaller tasks, and then we've gone through all of the things that I'm currently working on or working towards on my Ironman. So today we're going to be doing the same. We've done quite a lot of our long-term goals over the past 6 months to a year. So I think it's time, being closer to the end of 2021, which has flown by, am I right? I think it's time that we sit down and go through what we're going to be looking at for the next couple of months and the next year or so. And also, we'll kind of do a bit of a refresher on how to break down your goals, how to set your own goals, and maybe some of the ones that I've got can inspire some of the things that you want to do on your account and take into your future goals. Before we do get into going through all of the sort of tabs you can see at the bottom there, a lot of people have been asking in the last video that I did on this, and also sort of in my Ironman progression videos and on Discord as well, if I'm going to make a template for this, which I actually have. So down in the description you will find a link to where you can access that file and you can download it, and you can start using that if you want to as kind of a base for a lovely spreadsheet, because who doesn't love a good spreadsheet, of how you can start tracking your goals, and you can kind of see how I've broken down all of my stuff as well. But with that being said, let's get straight into it. So if we go over to the goals section, we can see that it's probably a lot more colourful than the last time we had a look at it. We can see it's also been broken down a lot more. We've got a lot more goals in there as well. So short-term goals are kind of things I'm looking at doing within the next sort of 4 weeks, 6 weeks, which kind of boils down to about 4 weeks, about 4 to 6 episodes of my Iron Progression series, to give you an idea of how that works. So we can see kind of color wise I've got a key there which shows the kind of lighter yellow is level 99s. Green ones would be complete, which we'll get onto later. We then got diary prerequisites were in orange. We then got a light blue, which is, or kind of a pale blue, which is quest prerequisites. We then got the kind of darker yellow, which is diaries. Grey, which is quests that are non-requirement related, so they're not requirements for other quests or diaries. We then got purple, which is drops or items. Darker blue, which is capes. Another lighter blue, which is mini quests, which kind of links to the quest as well. Then we've got log completion, which is in dark orange. We've then got kind of a darker salmony colour, which is bossing slash raids objectives. And then we've got that kind of cyany blue, which is for pets. So like I said, short terms are about 4 to 6 weeks. Medium terms are probably about 2 to 6 months. And then long terms are about 6 months to a year, or just things that I'm working towards passively. So for example, like I said before with pets are... How lucky you're feeling today, my friend. So yeah, that's why you probably see quite a lot of the higher drop rate drops are in the medium and longer term goals, just because, you know, RNG is a big factor in RuneScape, right? There's no way that you can set in stone unless you're going to absolutely camp thousands upon thousands upon thousands of kills of a certain boss, which, if you know me, you know my playstyle. I can only do things for so long before I need to switch it up, otherwise I get bored or burnt, which we don't want to do. But yeah, that's kind of the timeline ideas for the different term goals. So just quickly skimming over the kind of short-term things, there's a few quests in there because one of my main objectives for the next year, I guess, is going to be getting the quest cape. As someone who hates questing, it's one thing that I've probably put on the back burner a lot. I've been working on my account now for about 3.5 years. Haven't got a quest cape yet, and that's because I just can't be arsed. I don't like questing. I don't like achievement diaries necessarily. If I do them, I do them. If there's a decent reward, you know. But yeah, that's kind of why you probably see sprinkled in there a few easy diaries and a few medium diaries as well, scattered about. And why there's quite a few quests left still to do. But my main goal, one of my main goals for this year coming, is to obtain the quest cape. There's a lot of drops in there you probably see as well, kind of a variety of stuff. We've got in there some God Wars. We've got in there some Barrow stuff as well, Zolra drops. And then we've got some big boy items like the Dragon Warhammer. But in the short terms, we've got the Cudgel. Seracnis is one boss that I'd like to complete very early on in the year. We've then got Arim's Top and Bottoms, which if you've been following the series for a while, you know I've been hunting those for since I started at Barrows, which I've now got nearly 900 KC. Still haven't got either of those. Got a million of all the everything else, but not them two. We've then got a Nezzy Face Guard. I just need to sit down and grind out the Basilisk Knights, whatever they are. But you know what I mean. Infinity Boots. Infinity Boots are on there. I'm thinking about binning them off because I do have Brimstone Boots, which, you know, will do me fine. So I'm thinking about binning those off. Then again, if I did get the crystal from a big red dog, I probably would need to get them anyway, wouldn't I? Probably would need to get them. We've got KVD heads in there. KVD is one boss that I really want to sit down and start bashing out some KCs. Seer's Ring, I've recently started doing Prime. So Seer's Ring will come pretty soon. I've actually got a guide coming out soon on how to do Rex and Prime together. So look out for that. Then we've got some KCs in there with Gauntlet because we've been doing a lot of Gauntlet lately. And Zolcano because I'm not Prif lately. you start to see a theme here, how things link together. Then we've got base stats level 70. I think it's only runecrafting now that I really need to get up. 85 farming. We're on 83 or 4 at the moment. So pretty close to that. 80 prayer, just because it's our last combat stat that's not 80. 92 magic. We are incredibly close to halfway. So that's on there. 80 herb lore. Pretty easy, that one. 91 slayer, just to unlock Clifford the Big Red Dog. And then we've got a few quests in there that shouldn't be too painful. And then we've got, in the medium tier, we've got some diaries that need doing because they've got some prerequisites. And we got some other drops in there that are a bit more grindy, like the blowpipe, the God Sword there, Zami God Sword, the Bando's chest plate. They're just things that I really need to just get into the swing of learning. They're not necessarily things I haven't done before, but not very well. If you've watched any of my God Wars stuff, you know it's always single kill trips and they're pretty scuffed. We just about get by. But that's why those are in the medium term goals, because they're something we're just going to be working on. Not at the moment, but they're in the near future. We then got in there. I've got Quest Cape in there twice. Ignore that. Ignore that. There we go. So, there we go. Cool. We've then got some diaries in here. We've got some quests that are for the desert medium. I haven't really done any desert diaries. As you can see, the easy one's still there. So that's definitely something that I want to knock on the head early in the year coming. We've then got to complete the pest control log. I really want to start working towards getting the collection log completed. Not completed, but, you know, some things in green and not just... he's kind of got a couple of the drops. So that's one of the another thing that I'm passively working on as well. We then got, I guess, moving on to the long-term goals, pets, 99s, woodcutting, cooking, and fishing. We're both, all three of those we're really close to. It's just putting in the time. Magic, it's one that's going to come pretty quick, I think. It's like we've got 99 strength in medium as well. I probably should put 99 hit points is there as well, because I'm literally one level away, where strength I am a couple of levels away. Whereas with magic, we're 91 at the moment. Crafting is something that if we put the time into, we can get it pretty quick, but it's sitting in long term for now. And then we've got some big boy drops. The Pharaoh Scepter, I'm probably going to move that to medium term, maybe short term soon. Because I do want to finish off the altar in my house so I can use all the different spell books. We've then got Tob 1KC. That's only there because, as in that far out, it's because I haven't really done much Tob before, so I really need to get on later on in the year and learn it. Base 80 stats, base 90 stats, 2000 total level. Those are things that are probably going to get moved out to the following year, I'm not going to lie. And then we've got some other quests on there. I think they're mini quests there, just because I was like, I'll stick them on the end. And then we've got complete Temporos log and Glau's experiments logs, as in demonic gorillas. We're pretty close to both. They're just things that I'm just going to work on as and when, really. But yeah, that kind of covers off really all of my goals for now. There will be a few things that get sprinkled in throughout the year as I kind of maybe realize I've missed something out, or we've got new content coming out. So Next comes out early next year. I think it's 15th of Jan or something like that. So there'll definitely be some Next stuff on the list of things to do as well. And you can see this also out here on the right-hand side here. We've got my currently diary tracker. So green obviously means completed. Yellow means that they currently have tasks done on them. And then the number on there is how many tasks I have left to complete that diary. And then the ones without any color on them are ones that I haven't even started yet. But just to give an idea of how the diaries are doing, there's a little table for you. So one thing that I do like to do is track everything that I've been completing, you know. So what I've done is I've actually put together a timeline of the Iron Man episodes, of everything that we've been doing in each episode, what we've been ticking off. It only starts from 24, because I think that's when I started the spreadsheet. So we've been using it a long while, you know. We've been using it a long while, but as we go through the timeline, we can see all the kind of stuff that we've been up to. And you can pause the video if you want to read some of these, if you want to get some ideas for yourself. But to give you an idea of the pacing, to give an idea of what we've been up to over time, if you don't follow the series, I haven't put the dates on these, but I probably should. That's what we've been up to. But yeah, that's just a quick one for the timeline of progression. So now there was one thing that I was doing last episode of my Iron Man progression, which was doing locking myself at Gauntlet for a week, and I put together a GP tracker. I'm thinking about doing one for revs as well, because I've started doing some revs and I want to see how much money we can make there. But that's kind of an idea of how I've been tracking, you know, the trips I've been doing, when I've been doing them, KCs, everything like that, and then money made. And I did include some screenshots, but it starts making the file quite big if you start whacking in a load of them, doesn't it? So moving on to the next tab is one that we went through similarly before with Dragon Slayer 2, but Song of the Elves was one of the bigger goals that I ticked off recently. Here was just how we were breaking down the overall goal of Song of the Elves, working out the steps that we needed to do beforehand, with some optional ones. I guess 94 Magic was an optional one as well. We didn't actually need Venge. But yeah, that was kind of how we broke it down, looking at what we needed to do left, putting them in a step by step, and then just cracking through them. A better one is probably the Dragon Slayer 2 one, as all of them were actual ones that I needed to do. So get 200 quest points. Then I went on to do Lunar Diplomacy, then went and got 70 smithing, then did the rest of the quests required, and then got it done, you know. And then I guess I have been through this one before, but obviously it's been updated since we last went through this, because I've got some new stuff unlocked and done some stuff. Hopefully ticked off a few goals, but we can kind of see how I set myself my goal of doing Zolra, set myself things that I needed to get, so attain the Trident, cure me, then get my first KC, then start working towards more KCs, then learn different options of these as well, so learning only with magic, then learning with void, then learning with my best in slots, and then starting to get our time down, then working on some upgrades, getting the MA2 cape, getting a fury. That one's done. upgrading to a suffering. And now we've got the Aaron's top and bottom that I need to get. I want to get a blessed D-high body, even though I can use Carol's if I want to. And then blowpipe is a drop that obviously comes from Zolra. So that'll be something that we get from... I need to take that one off as well. That'll be obviously something we get from doing more Zolra as well. And then the sub 2 minute and sub 1 minute kills, they'll come once we start getting upgrades and we start getting better and better. But yeah, that's kind of how I've broken down a bossing goal. Again, I think I went through this in my last video on my goals. So if you want a bit more clarity on how I defined all of these, and these are just references to goals that were in my lists as well. So you can see, you know, where they've been ticked off or where they're currently sitting in my goals list. So Aram's top, like we saw, is right there, sitting on there. But yeah, that's kind of how I've broken down my bossing goals. So you can kind of see main sort of big goals, like a big quest, one of the Grandmaster quests, and then you can see kind of how I'm looking into a boss that I'm working on as well. Right, so now we move on to something I went through definitely before, which was tracking all of the stash units around Gilanor and, you know, the statuses. Have I got them filled? Have I got them built? I think there's a couple more of these that I have done. But we can start to see that, you know, we've got all of the medium ones done, all of the easy, all of the beginners. I probably should start putting in the elite and master ones now, as I actually have the construction level to start making those. But again, this one's in the template file that I've put together. So if you do want to use this, this is a lot of copying and pasting from the wiki and sorting out formatting and everything. And these are all bound to these finished percentages and stuff. So it works it all out for you. And it also tracks how many you've done as well. So I don't know, that's me typing that. Anyway, you get the point. You can link it in. But yeah, quite a nice thing to track. It also means you can see where different items are in around Gillenor if you do need to access them. Because it all gets a bit messy, your bank account, if you start storing all of this shite in it. I've also been one thing I do want to start putting together is the a similar thing for the storage within the house, because one of my goals is to actually complete the storage in the house. I have every single slot that you can store things in the house filled. That's quite a nice little goal that I say little, it's fucking massive, isn't it? It's one thing that I am looking towards doing, because I would like to utilize the house as much as possible. I think it's one of the best things in the game, so it's definitely something I want to maximize its potential for. But yeah, that's kind of stashes, and it will be a similar thing to this on the player-owned house storage. Again, another thing I guess tracking is to do with barrows. We can see what items we have left. This isn't the most up-to-date version. I think I've got 850 something like that. And then a few more items that we've got. But you can see, you know, what things we've got left, what we're still hunting, what items Barrows loves giving me, like Torag's hammers and Arim's staves. But it's another thing. Again, I've included this as a completely clear one that you can put in all of your cases and counts of items and what ones you've got on the template file. And it also will calculate your rate of getting drops as well, which I think is quite nice. Yeah. But then the last thing here is just kind of another archive of all the completed stuff that I've done. But yeah, I guess that really covers, you know, the goals file that I've put together and what I'm currently working on. Gives you kind of a look behind the scenes on what to expect within the series coming up, and what you can expect to see from videos over the next foreseeable future. Going by the very positive response from the Gauntlet video that I did last week, I'm trying to think of what day it is. Yeah, last week, of locking myself at a certain boss or a certain activity for a while, for like a week. I definitely think I'll be doing some more of those. So you can expect to see some content based around that. But yeah, I hope you guys have found this video useful. A nice little, like I said, a peer behind the curtain to see what's going on in Smithy TV, you know. But yeah, let me know what you think in the comments down below. Let me know what your goals are currently. Let me know what you're working towards, if there's any bosses that you're working on. And also shit on me about my horrible luck on getting a Xenite, because that took way too long and burnt through a lot of resources with that. Nearly burnt myself out. Wahey! Let's go! But yeah, no, I hope you guys have enjoyed. If you are new around here, fucking dry ass video that you've joined on, mate, but drop a subscription and you'll get notified of when all my videos go up. A shout out to all of our channel members of Steve, Damo, Will, and Super Beef. Everyone over a tier one membership gets a shout out at the end of the video. So if you are interested in that, hit the join button, give you all the information you need. But yeah, the comment for this episode is spreadsheet egg. I want to see spreadsheet egg in the comments. Spam it down there. And if you don't want to put that, put anything you like, because commenting really does help with push videos out in the algorithm, and it's much appreciated. But I'm going to love you and leave you. Stay safe. Come join the Discord, and I'll see you all in the next video. Bye.